zooplankton in River Sone in Bhujpur region, Bihar. The entire major project was based on study of phytoplankton and zooplankton and their correlation with various biodiversity indices. But this is a small paper in that form. Next slide, please. Next slide, please. Yes, okay. Okay. Next slide, please. Yes.
Right.
Okay. Now, first of all, I'd like to tell that what is zooplankton? Zooplanktons are a type of heteromorphic plankton that range from microscopic to large size species. They are non-motile and weak swimmers, usually which drift with water. They move in sunlight zone usually, where food resources are abundant. They have been reported to be very good bioindicator for free water bodies. I have selected this for my study for because we are they are very good. They are very sensitive to the rapid changes in the aquatic environment and so they put a very rapid response, so it is easy to access them and they work as a very good bioindicators. Now they play very important role in food web by linking the primary producers, so I have selected this study. And the freshwater zooplankton usually comprises of protozoa, rotifera, cladocerans, copepods and osteichords. I have just mainly focused on rotifera, cladocerans, copepods and osteichord studies because protozoa was difficult to, they are very of nano size and so many equipments not available to me. And so most of the protozoans are usually not sampled due to their minor size. And these are the process of what we have followed in assessment. Now these are rotifers. Rotifers are the most important soft-bodied metazoans in vertebrate, having a very short life cycle among the planktons. Only they although they come under microphyla, but they work as a very good bioindicators. Only 100 widely spread rotifer species are planktonic and their life cycles are influenced by temperature, food and water period. Dhanapati 12, me also in 2017, reported that they increase in large quantity rapidly under favorable environmental conditions. Now next is the cladocerans. They are a crucial group among zooplankton and form the most useful nutritive group of crustaceans for higher members of fishes in the food chain. This group feeds on small zooplankton, bacterial plankton and algae. Now copepods. Copepods, they are the toughest exoskeleton and longest and strongest appendages. They are the most sustainable of all the zooplanktons. And they are easy to recognize also. Now, they come under three families, cycloid copepods, calanoid copepods, and herpacticoid copepods under three orders based on their feeding habits. Now, cycloid copepods feed on algae, they feed on algae, bacteria, and detritus. Calanoid copepods feed on, they also on ciliates and rotifers, and they are herpacticoid copepods are primarily benthic. Osteichords are mainly bottom dwellers of river and live on detritus and dead phytoplankton. These organisms are food of fish and benthic macroinvertebrates. Now, the growth and distribution of zooplankton are dependent on these mostly these factors. The that was a part of my research, major research project, the study of physicochemical parameter. First part was that. So I just tried to put the factors which affect them. There's the abiotic parameters. These are affect them very rapidly, and the biotic parameters often. That biotic parameters are necessary to mention that the food limitation, predation, and competition in their environment available. Now, these are the material and methods, what I follow standard method of AFA and WHO. Now, about 12 species diversity indices have been studied in the project, but I mainly focused on four of them, species diversity index, and species richness index, equitability index, and dominance index in this paper. Now, in investigation, 11 species of rotifers, including 2 families and 5 genera, 7 species of cladocerans, 5 families and 6 genera, 5 species of copepod, including 3 families and 5 genera, and 3 species of long gastropods were found. So, on the crustacean population reported were Daphnia, Cyclop, Nautilus, and Mesocyclops. They are very good pictures, which I would like to show you. Now, two species of hymenosomatid crustacean near Incas Patnahi, which was also reported by Nagan and co-worker in River Sone near Patna. I have also reported that two species, hymenosomatid crustacean near Inca Plex Patnahi. Now, composition of zooplankton was strongly affected by, as I have mentioned now. Now, the factors which I found that the density of ratifers was maximum in February and minimum at summer in May. Cladocerin density maximum during winter 45.83 and minimum during the pre-monsoon in 31.63 during pre-monsoon. Copepods for their maximum density during summer 26.95 and minimum density to 16.66 during winter. Osteichords for their maximum density during summer and minimum during winter. That means different zooplanktons show their density differently in different seasons. Now, we cannot say that all the zooplanktons dominate in monsoon or pre-monsoon or something like that. But maximum zooplankton are reported during the month of post-monsoon, August to September. Now, this is the overall figure of the different species what I have reported. Now, the values for biodiversity indices, that is Simpson index, dominance index, and four indices are in next table, but I'm going to show. And this is the table one where different indices are there. I have mentioned that. Now, some of the species, very good pictures of the species I've got there. In the collaboration with the Bihar Pollution Control Board, they have assisted me in getting that. And these are the graph, what I've got, composition of zooplankton in terms of density. And in terms of volume, and this is the correlation matrix of the physicochemical variables of Sone River. And then finally, I would like to conclude that zooplankton population this river in Bhojpur area, river Sone comes from Sone Muda in MP, but starts from here. But in that region, Bhojpur region, it is represented by 21 species and population are highly sensitive to changes in physicochemical parameter river. So they are good bioindicator reflecting the health and pollution status of the river. The correlation of various diversity indices and dominance of rotifers indicate semi-polluted state of river Sone in this area. Now I'm thankful to my assistant and research scholar Priti Patiba for her assistance. These are some references I would like to mention and this book. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, madam.
It was during rainy season, sir.
But this time of the day.
This time of the day? It's a.
And why?
Because sunlight is there. Page is. I reported in the morning and then in the evening, sir, mostly. And I found it lower in the evening. That was not a part of my study.
Okay, hello. What question?
Okay.
You have reported number of species, how many species?
21 species.
21 species. Yes. But this is based on morphology?
Yes, mostly morphology.
Have you tried for molecular phylogeny?
No, no. We don't have facilities of molecular phylogeny in my department.
Because this species are in the same already reported.
No, I haven't studied the molecular phylogeny. I've just focused on their density, biovolume, and identification.
Because see, doing that, you may get new species. And that is
yes, of course.
So one species. New species in your ecosystem
that
you are collected.
That I was sent to Bihar Pollution Control Board for identification. They have put out the previous record. Presently Professor Ghosh is the chairman. He has assisted me in finding out that.
No, my suggestion is that you can go for that kind of study so that you can discover new species.
Okay, sir.
Like molecular phylogeny.
I want to do that. Okay. I would like to be, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Any more questions?
No, see, yes, you can do that now. Provided you have these facilities.
Yes, yes.
You can go ahead with that kind of work.
I need a collaboration, sir, to do for the work.
Yeah,
I have prepared some of the projects. I need some collaboration. I'm looking for that. I'm trying for that. Thank you, each and everybody.
Thank you
for the lovely students of ABC University for my patience hearing. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Sunita. And last last presentation will be one more by Vivek Talni, Devgiri College, Aurangabad.
Save. Recording chal raha hai. Save karna. Ye dabana hai. Tu bhi jaana hai.